Hello, my name is Ryan Robbins, and today we will be going over the internal expansion process for the 15-ton Ram. The 15-ton Ram is used only for internal expansion. The internal expansion of couplings allows for full flow in a hose assembly, minimizing the buildup of material around the coupling shank and providing a strong permanent connection to the hose. When being expanded, the coupling body is pushed from the inside out, locking the hose between the furl and the expanded hose stem. Today, we will be reviewing the steps from start to finish to help you achieve a successful internal expansion using the 15-ton Ram. First, ensure that the adapter plate bolted to the face of the ram is correct. For hold-all petroleum fittings, the adapter plate should have three prongs. For this example, we'll be using a 1 3/8 hold-all petroleum fitting, so we will need the three-prong adapter. If the adapter plate is incorrect, use a 3/8 inch Allen wrench to remove the bolts and replace the adapter plate with the correct one. For all internally expanded fittings with an ID less than 2 inches, such as in this 1 3/8 inch example, thread the small rod adapter into the face of the ram. This adapter is about 3 inches long and has both internal and external threads. Thread the second longer rod into the adapter. This rod is 5/8 inch in diameter and has threads on either end and is about 11 inches long. Place the push plate over the rods and onto the three-prong adapter plate. Notice these stems have a white coating on the inside, and that's because they come pre-lubricated from the factory. No additional lubricant is necessary. Place the stem with the large end facing the ram into the hex opening in the push plate. Notice there are extra openings in the push plate. This is so female fittings, which have lugs, can be used with the same push plate. Following the stem, push the correct plug into the shank end of the stem. Due to limited space in the ram, make sure all threads are tightened as far as possible while still allowing play for adjustments later on. Flip the switch on the hydraulic pump to the hold position. Press and hold the foot pedal until the top end of the plug is covering a small portion of the rod threads. At the base of the threaded adapter, thread on the retaining nut until snug against the plug. There should be no movement from the stem or plug between the retaining nut and the push plate. Accurately measure the hose OD with a diameter tape and select the correct furl based on this measurement. Do this for both ends of the hose. Refer to the chart for correct hose insertion length. Make sure the hose end is cut square. Measure and mark the hose at the correct insertion length dimension to ensure proper space is left during the expansion process for the rubber displacement. Slide the hose and furl over the plug and stem. The top of the furl should sit in the groove of the stem, while the bottom of the furl sits at the mark. Remove all objects, including fingers, from the ram at this time. Press the foot pedal until the expansion is complete. You should feel a release in tension, which indicates the part is past the plug. Once complete, remove the hose assembly from the ram. Flip the switch on the hydraulic pump to the return position, and allow the cylinder to fully retract to its original position before moving on to the next part. Remove the retaining nut and the plug, and wipe away all lubrication residue from the plug before assembling the next end. Inspect the hose end for damage to either the hose or fittings. For the next example, we'll be using a 2-inch hold-all petroleum fitting, so we will leave the 3-prong adapter bolted into the ram. Remove all rods from the ram. For all internally expanded fittings with an ID 2 inches or larger, such as in this 2-inch example, thread the large rod adapter into the face of the ram. This adapter is 12 inches long and has only external threads. Place the push plate around the adapters and onto the 3-prong adapter plate. This stem is also pre-lubricated, so no additional lubrication is necessary. Place the stem with the large end facing the ram into the hex opening in the push plate. There are extra openings specific for lugs on female fittings on this push plate as well. Following the stem, push the correct plug into the shank end of the stem. Due to limited space in the ram, make sure all threads are tightened as far as possible while still allowing play for adjustments later on. Flip the switch on the hydraulic pump to the hold position. To reduce the amount of distance for the retaining nut, press and hold the foot pedal until the end of the plug is at a point closer to the end of the rod. At the base of the rod, thread on the retaining nut until snug against the plug. There should be no movement from the stem or plug between the retaining nut and the push plate. Accurately measure the hose OD with a diameter tape and select the correct furrow based on this measurement. Do this for both ends of the hose. Refer to the chart for correct hose insertion length. Make sure the hose end is cut square. Measure and mark the hose at the correct insertion length dimension to ensure proper space is left during the expansion process for the rubber displacement. Slide the hose and furrow over the plug and stem. The top of the furrow should sit in the groove of the stem, while the bottom of the furrow sits at the mark. Remove all objects, including fingers, from the ram at this time. Press the foot pedal until the expansion is complete. You should feel a release in tension, which indicates the part is past the plug. Once complete, remove the hose assembly from the ram. Flip the switch on the hydraulic pump to the return position and allow the cylinder to fully retract to its original position before moving on to the next part. Remove the retaining nut and the plug and wipe away all lubrication residue from the plug before assembling the next end. Inspect the hose end for damage to either the hose or fittings.
Thank you for watching this video on how to use the 15-ton ram.
If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please contact us at DixonValve.com. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.